சொல்லுங்க சார். என்னாச்சு? எனக்கும் தெரியல என்னாச்சு. அது தெரியுது, ஆரம்பிச்சிச்சா? யாருக்கும்
Good morning to one and all present here. I am Ramesh, Head Department of Physics, Vivekananda College of Arts and Science for Women, Autonomous. First, I would like to thank our management for giving the permission to conduct the webinar section. Thank you, sir. And I heartily welcome to our chief guest, Dr. S. Gokulraj, Assistant Professor, Kandaswamy Naidu College for Men, Chennai. I welcome you, sir, and I heartily welcome Resource Person Dr. T. Beena, Assistant Professor, Senior Grade, SRM Institution, Ramapuram Campus. I welcome you, ma'am. And I heartily welcome to our Physical Science Dean, Dr. G. Gandipan, sir. I welcome you, sir. And I heartily welcome to Bioscience Dean, Dr. T. Shankar. I welcome you, sir. And I heartily welcome to one and all present here. I welcome to other college professor, associate professor, assistant professor, and a research scholar, and my dear students. I heartily welcome to all for the grand section, grand success for the webinar section. Thank you.
Shall I start, sir? Yes. Can you see the screen? Yeah. Okay, I'll continue, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes. Good morning to all. First of all, thank you for your introduction, sir. And I should thank the organizers for this opportunity. And I heard from the organizers that you can treat, you can repair or replace any body tissue functions of the body. The diagnostic one is to find out the defect or find out that is present in the body. So for two purposes, we have been using this biomaterial. So before going into the details in biomaterials, we should know the property of biocompatibility. Now, what do you mean by biocompatibility? Coming to the ceramic implants, ceramic biomaterials. This ceramic material, particularly the calcium phosphate, they bonds on the surface over a period of time so that a protein bond sites will be formed. So alumina is a good ceramic implant which is used for the prosthesis, that is femoral, and in the carbon materials, particularly used as a ceramic material which is highly compatible with the bone and other tissues. And also the bioglass ceramics, so all these which I have shown here, they are implants. The bioglass ceramics, which contains a fluoride, they acquire as a fibrous capsule over the rat femurs. So all these are ceramic materials which is a highly biocompatible one. Even the glass ceramics can be used as a fillers in the bone cement. Coming to polymeric implants play a very, very vital role in the field of biomaterial, because almost all the materials, most of the materials are polymeric implants. Even the sutures in operations, the doctors use the sutures which is made up of a polymeric implant. The gloves, all these are made up of polymers which can be used as a biomaterial. So it is nothing but the polymers are nothing but a synthetic or natural materials which have been interfaced with the biological system either to regenerate or to repair any type of tissues or functional body. So this actually it plays a very, very vital role in tissue engineering. When compared with metals and ceramics, polymers, they show very better representation of natural tissue response when compared with metals and ceramics. A very good example I can give, which is polymethyl methacrylate, which is used as a cornea substitute in eyes. Coming to the properties, see, like other materials, electronic, photonic materials, there are many properties. Similar biomaterial properties are also very, very important. As it is, we cannot implant the material, right? We have to concentrate about the properties of the materials, like mechanical properties, thermal properties, optical, electrical, surface rate, and all physical properties of this biomaterials. By analyzing this, by studying this only, we can use it as an implant material. Now, we know what is a biomaterial, we know the types, we know the application, but we cannot use as an implant material. So there are certain steps involved in the development of biomaterial devices. First of all, we should the need, where we need the biomaterial, what is the need of it. Then based on the need, you have to devise the design. Once a device is designed, choose a material and you have to synthesize the material. Then you have to subject that for material testing. Then it is fabricated with fine tools. After that, you have to pack it. Once again, you will test it and then you can use it for clinical use. And a very important point is the lifespan of biomaterial. So each and every biomaterial has a particular lifespan. Example, which you are very familiar, a doctor who did an operation in the leg, the broken leg is replaced with some stainless steel rods. After 10 years you have to do with the, we have to go with another operations there, we have to replace the stainless steel rod with a new one, because if the lifespan of this is just 10 years. So each and every biomaterial have its own lifespan. I can give you some more examples, like hemodialysis as a metallic implant, it can be used in dental implant, orthopedic, venetic part, you can use it as a bone replacement. A polymeric, if you take as a polymeric implant, it is actually like a drug delivery devices, even materials where you can see biosensors. I'll tell you what is biosensors, right? So some more applications of biomaterial as an implant material, Biomaterial is used to assist in healing. It is used to correct some cosmetic problems. It is used to action. It is used to correct some functional abnormalities. It is used as an aid for treatment and also to diagnose the in all these we can do with the biomaterials. Now different systems or different systems in which where these biomaterials can. So starting with the skeletal systems where you have a joint replacement, there the titanium and stainless steel were used. When we say about fixation, the titanium screws are used, stainless steel screws are used, and for bone cement, polymethyl methacrylate are used. For dental implants, titanium. So when you talk about cardiovascular system, biomaterial play a very very vital role, like in blood vessel processes, a Teflon and Dacron is used. Heart wall, ceramic implant is used, even reprocessed tissue is also used. So catheter is made up of a silicone rubber, it's a polymeric implant. So not parts, even the organs we can transplant, organs we can use it as a biomaterial. That is, you can make a artificial heart using polyurethane. Artificial kidney you can use with the cellulose. Artificial lung machine can be used with silicone rubber, right? And even in sensors, the cochlear replacement. In the ear, you have a very small bone with cochlear bone. When there is a damage in the cochlear bone, you can replace it with platinum electrodes. Even eyes, in the intraocular lenses, hydrogels can be used. Contact lens, the lens, the hydrogels, which is a polymeric implant. So there are a lot of applications of biomaterials. I showed you some pictures about the applications of biomaterials, like how it is used as a contact lens, the heart walls, the hip replacement, the stent replacements, the vascular grafts. So this picture will tell you about actually this is actually a heart wall fabricated from bends. Even you can make it with carbon, metal, elastomers. A very important thing is it must not react with chemicals in the body. The biomaterial should not react with the chemicals, because our body consists of biological fluids. So those fluids, that fluid should not react with the biomaterial. So in this heart wall, you have a polyester mesh, and this has been implanted. And also on the right side, you can see a heart wall where it is implanted so that the cardiac function is restored to near normal. So many replacements are going on every year all over. So this is actually a vascular graft. So the blood vessel damage can be replaced with the vascular grafts. So it should be flexible. Actually, you can see in the second picture how they are replaced. The blood vessel replacement, they have been replaced with the vascular grafts. So it must be open, porous structure, flexible. And the handling property should also be good. And very particular is biostable, that is biocompatible. And when we have dental implants, you can see the screws here. We all know about the root canal treatment, how the screws, the titanium screws have been used to support the bone. Picture will tell you the bonding to the bone, capable of bonding to the bone. We call it as osseointegration. It won't interact. Actually, it is a biomaterial. Bioinert is minimal interaction. It will not interact with the bone, the surrounding tissues, but it will give support to the tissues. Support, right? So such implants have been used in dentistry. And this is actually pre-placements where you use metallic implants, which is of corrosion resistance. And this is actually the lens which is used for cataract patients. 50%, we all know 50% of population suffers with cataract. So as soon as this is replaced, this is made up of polymethyl or silicone elastomer. When it is replaced to the patient, good vision is generally restored immediately after the lens is inserted. And this is actually a femur bone, a thigh bone broken, and it is replaced with the metallic implants. And even the knee is artificial implant materials, that is biomaterial. And the damaged teeth is replaced with the artificial implant materials, dental implants. Sort of uses are there in the biomaterial field, where you replace the damaged part with any artificial hip joints, kidney dialysis. You can heal it by using sutures and body parts, body plates or bone plates, or you can correct the abnormality. Even you can cosmetic problems, either by mammoplasty or by chin augmentation, you can correct the defect which is present in our face. Slide will tell you complete the total hip replacement. So the starting with the first is a hip, the damaged hip part, which has been completely replaced by step by step. And they, in the fourth picture, you can see they have replaced acetabular cup and screw arrangement. And finally, it is to totally removed. The damaged part is removed and it is replaced with a stainless steel rods and ceramics. So this is again a very, very implant materials, commonly hip replacement. And this is actually the dental implants. You can see how the screws are being implanted like a root canal. This is nothing but the root canal treatment. And if there is any damage in the face, oral maxillofacial be used. By using titanium screws, you can correct the feature of the face if it has been damaged. So all these biomaterials. And this is the stent which I have already, the pulse to the, it helps the heart to pump correctly. So it is one of an implant material. And you can see the carbon fiber prosthetics by a person with a broken bone. This can be replaced with a carbon fiber. Women who has used this carbon fiber prosthetic in new tissues. And the scaffold, the material what you have chosen for support, that to complete. You cannot find out the scaffold later because it completely dissolves in the system. Newly grown tissue that blends with the surrounding. Definitely you can replace the damaged one with a new one like a natural tissue. So this picture will tell you about cell harvest, and with the help of scaffold, totally reconstruct or replace the damaged tissues similar to that of natural tissues. It is a recent development going on. Not only they were using the conventional materials like metal, ceramics and synthetic polymers. In addition to that, nowadays they have started to design self-assembling biomaterial. That is, they designed to provide some biological functions so that it can mimic as much as possible by mimic the natural tissue itself. So you the biomaterials are introduced in such a way that the biological function will mimic the natural tissue structures. And nowadays they have merged the stem cell technology and tissue engineering so that these two will enhance. The combination of enhanced cell viability, differentiation, even the therapeutic efficacy of the transplanted stem cells. And the scaffolds have been used in tissue engineering with good mechanical properties. It is again a big challenge when they have started tissue engineering. The scaffold is not at a good level, but it is a great challenge now. The scientists are working in that so that the mechanical properties are advanced mechanical properties are there, which will support the growth of tissue engineering. And a further challenge is healing rate. So these are advancements. And also, instead of using synthetic polymers, natural polymers like cellulose and starches, they have started using, scientists have started using that, so the synthetic polymers can be avoided. So this picture will tell you the combination of material factors, stem cells, these two combined. And they have been used in 3D biomaterials. 3D printing, I think you all heard about this, is actually the latest one. You can design the tissues, cells, a material is taken, a biomaterial in the form of solution is taken with the cells, and you can design, you can print it according to the, and you can use it for different applications. So these are the latest developments in the recent developments in biomaterial. So I have given you a chart year of 1950 to 1970. We call it as a first generation biomaterials. Just metals and alloys were used. Stainless steel, titanium. But 80 to 1990s, the bioceramics and polymers, they have started using with the collagen, bioactive biomaterials. Then in 1990 to 10, some nano composites they have started using as a bioactive and resorbable. But the future, that is the fourth generation, we are going to the fourth, we have started our four till 2010 to 2013. Tissue engineering plays a very vital role with the biomimic biomaterials. That is, it mimics the original. We are preparing a biomaterial with the function, biological function, which will mimic the original tissue itself. So whether it is one which you have prepared or one which is original, both will be same because it mimics just the original one. So these are the latest advancements, recent advancements in biomaterials. Like what I said as bio inks for 3D, they are widely used. They have started, scientists are working in that and they have started using this. So these are the latest development, recent developments in the field of biomaterials. So when we talk about the future scope actually, digital instrument is used where the surgeons can use the thumbs and fingers. A robot, you can see three arm robot, you can that two arms were used which contains the miniature instruments which are inserted into the patient's ports in the patient. Surgeon from outside, when the surgeons movements, it will be transformed, a large motion will be transformed to a remote control as a micro movement. So what happened, the robo arms to it will do it will improve the mechanical precision and safety. And the robot is holding a miniature camera which is inserted through a small opening into the patient. So the surgeons no need to do operations in direct contact with them. Actually, with the help of the robot, they can do the operations with magnified images, so that a broad view of the interior surgical site you can see. And this has started using in USA, and they are currently approved for gallbladder, prostate, colorectal, gynecology, so many procedures they have started using this surgical robots. So when you talk about the challenges, first of all, you should understand the extracellular and intracellular modulate of cell functions. And one more challenge is, you have to develop some novel material so that novel material and processing techniques that should be compatible with the biological interfaces. And also we have to find a better strategy for immune acceptance. So these are the challenges for the biomaterial community. Emerging industry, actually it is a very, very emerging industry, we all know. So the next generation should work in a relation between medical as the therapeutic modalities. So just by implantation, it's not getting over, and how we can cure it, the therapeutic modalities. So the relation between these two is very, very important. And the future scientists, one is to find out between a biotechnology and traditional engineering. So the relation between these two should be considered. So in this economic, in the period of COVID-19, there is a slowdown in world economy. The biomaterial industry has also suffered a lot, but still maintain a relatively optimistic growth. And when we talk about the market of biomaterials, in the year of 2018, total market of biomaterial is about $105 billion, but it will reach in the year of 2024, it will reach to $200 billion. So definitely there is a wide growth in the field of biomaterials with a 14.5% increase. So definitely it is an emerging and many, many recent advancements. Thank you. If you have any doubts, I'll post my mail box. You can send your questions there. I can clarify your doubts. Hello, sir. முடிஞ்சிருச்சு. ஓகே. ஓகே, வேற எப்படி டாக்ஸ் யூடியூப். ஓகே, ஐ சார், ஒன் மினிட். ஐயா, ஐ கேன் சி. Okay, I'll check your WhatsApp because I cannot see questions in this. Let me check in this. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Yes, one question I'll answer. I got a chat box. Why can't you use Can we replace titanium for replacement? Instead of using titanium, why can't you use some other material? See, titanium is very stable, particularly for dentistry, you have to go with the titanium screws. So in future, the research works are going on because titanium is expensive, and the research work is going on in that to find out an alternate. But till now, the titanium we use, there is no replacement for particular replacement. Particularly, we use it for titanium. So yes, why the titanium or stainless steel are used? Yes, metallic implants for giving support bones and tissues, you have to go with metallic implants. The damaged bone can be replaced with the metallic implants, not by calciums. One question they have, why we can't use calcium alone for bone damage? Why you go with stainless steel implants? Why you go with stainless steel implants? It is not possible because the bone need a stability, a support to withstand. So for calcium, you can take it as a supplement. But if a bone is completely broken, you can replace with stainless steel rods or titanium screws. No other option is there. Maybe in future, we can find out, by doing research, we can find out an alternate for this. Thank you. I'll share my mail ID in this. If you can clarify, you can send the questions to my mail ID. Definitely, I'll clear the doubts. Thank you. I thank the organizers for giving me opportunity. Thank you all. Hello, sir.